Ladies and gentlemen, Devin Foreman with the intro to Just Another Failure Podcast.
Wow, I just got an intro for our intro. Sick.
Welcome.
All right. Well, I was just going to go with... What's going on, everybody? Welcome to episode two of Just Another Failure Podcast.
I'm Maddie Sill.
I like that. I'm Devron...
Fairman.
Foreskin.
Foreskin.
Whoa. Just kidding. I'm Devin. That's Matt. What up?
What up?
Welcome to episode two.
You guys ready to hear
about Just
some,
Another Failure Podcast?
You guys ready to hear about some life lessons and some...
You ready to hear about...
Learning how to suck at life?
Because we're good at it.
We kill it.
We're fucking good at it.
Like, what... You want to talk about, like, best relationship failure?
Best relationship failure, huh?
I got a lot of those.
You do. You're really bad.
Professional friend zone? This guy. I probably have better ones than you.
Probably. I don't know. Is that something to brag about?
Hell yeah.
Cool.
People need to know what it's like to put yourself out there for a girl and just never get a response back.
Hey, what's up? You're like super beautiful and I'd love to take you on a nice romantic date. Hello? No, she's probably just busy right now.
She's cool. No, she's not with another guy. She'll hit me back.
She's going to hit me up.
Or my favorite one, like, oh my God, you fly airplanes? Yeah, I do. You want to take like me and my friends on a flight somewhere? By you and your friends who's a... What? Yeah, I can do that. Wait, why?
Do you want to take me and my boyfriend?
Why is there five dudes here today?
Oh, wow. These are all your friends?
Man, wow.
Oh. Thought it was just going to be like a me and you thing, but no, that's cool. No, it's super cool.
No, this tux looks fucking stupid anyways.
I wear this
every day.
This is just a joke. Funny.
I got you.
I was going to wear that sick shirt that he's wearing earlier too, but.
No, he's got dope shoes.
Yeah, he's better than me, but it's whatever.
No, I didn't mean to wear dress shoes. I usually wear Vans too. Fuck.
Yeah, big Vans guy. I'm a big Vans guy.
Big Vans guy.
I'm sorry, Matt.
I just suck at them. Like, is there like a book like on relationships?
Oh,
like,
yeah.
How to talk to a girl?
No.
Can this be taught?
No.
It's like common sense. No. You just got to have it.
No. Damn. Girls are just...
They're like, oh my God, you're like my brother. Yeah, my sisters tell me that all the time. Sorry, I'm already a brother.
Oh, cool. I'm your brother. Sweet.
Oh, that's what I've always wanted to be to a girl, like her brother. Because I don't have enough sisters already in life.
Matt is the epitome of that
dork.
That one video of that kid with the fake phone. So no head. And then he just slams him. That's Matt's whole relationship.
Oh, it's sad.
Condensed into one video.
It's
right
kind of funny though. Like if you just took all my attempts at having a relationship and just every attempt at me like trying to get with a girl and just put it all into a movie, it would be hilarious.
That would be funny.
Because there'd be like no closure. It would be like one of those like great like teen movies where like the guy's always trying to get the girl and at the end the girl falls in love with them because she realizes, but that doesn't happen with me.
It's just Matt saying stupid shit and pissing her off and then she leaves and then the happy ending part just doesn't happen.
We just missed the...
Shoot.
See, that's why I don't sell in Hollywood, because I didn't live happily ever after. I missed that part of life.
Wow, that was sad.
Mm-mm. No. It's not sad. It's funny. Hey, everyone.
Hey, you can look back on it now. And it's pretty funny, dude. It still hurts. Fuck.
No, it's like one of my favorite things. Like, hey, Matt, you want to go to a concert? You should bring a date. Yeah, hold on. Let me call one. Okay, yeah, she said she's coming. The concert comes around. Where's she at? She's busy.
You know,
she got off work late tonight.
She got sick again.
Yeah, again.
It's crazy. Fuck. It's just like whenever there's, you know,
something
that we're going to go do together, it's like she just gets sick.
All the time.
Like, man, the timing, man. It's crazy.
Every single time.
It's crazy.
You know,
I can't believe it happens like that.
Like go to a baseball game. Like, dude, you should totally bring a chick so you're not like the seventh wheel with us again. Yeah, hold on. No, I met this girl.
I totally got one.
I got a girl. No, it's sick. Yeah, she said she's down. Show up to the baseball game. Where? No, she's going to be late to the tailgate. I think she's coming like the third inning.
Dang.
It's more fun when you go to the movies and you just end up watching it by yourself.
Oh, God. fuck it. At least you get to watch a good movie and you get to focus on it. You don't got to fucking worry about if your breast stinks or anything.
Right? You don't have to worry about like the odd, like yeah, get your like, arm around her kind of thing, because that's never fun.
Doing that.
Is that what you... Wait, that... Hold on. That's how you do it?
I don't know. I don't think that move ever actually works.
I always accidentally like hit him in the face, like iron. Elbow. Oh, shit. Oh, my bad.
Uppercut shit. Their lip. Sock their big nose.
Or I'm just like too much of a weenie when I hang out with a girl. Like I don't put like... I either put like way too much effort in or I don't put enough... I'm not that middle ground guy. I'm not a good middler.
It's the fine line between being a rapist and...
being a fuck boy.
Being a nice guy and being a fuck boy.
Right. He's like, God, that guy's such a dick to me. I love him.
God, he is so unemotionally available. God, he's hot. But that guy that...
That guy's that so sweet, but he's like my brother.
But that guy that wants to settle down and have a marriage and buy a house? Ew. Oh, God.
God. He's so nice.
I'm going to ghost him.
I'm going to ghost that guy. Way too polite. Doesn't seem legit.
I'm gonna tell him I'm sick. You bitch. You bitch.
Why are you always getting off work late? Like all of a sudden you're always getting off work late.
I've never met someone that's, you know, so focused on work that has work this much. That's crazy.
So career oriented.
Yeah. Wow. Good for you.
God. And I thought my career sucked just being gone all the time.
Jesus. Speaking of careers, you want to talk about some pretty funny current topics with the career of athletes.
Gosh, what a disaster.
Because sports is trying to make its way back.
They're trying.
Sports is trying to come back right now.
What about the fact that the NBA is going to use the video game noise?
I love it. They're going to use 2K noises, fucking NBA 2K noises, the crowd noises to play on TV because there's no crowd. But so apparently they're all going to Orlando, right?
Yeah.
And they're going to all be in Disney World. They're all going to be locked down in Disney World.
Jealous.
But, I didn't even tell you this part either.
But I started reading about it. But
yeah, no, did you hear about Kyrie, though?
No.
So Kyrie...
Is he going to play like Goofy while he's at Disney World? He's going second?
No, he's talking... He's like suggesting that... The Nets and like some other players, well, like a bunch of other players, that they boycott the NBA season and start their own league. Like, what kind of a fucking stuck up prick are you?
Not gonna lie though, I'm kind of for it.
I mean, like,
no, like, kind of think about that though for a second. Like, we pay athletes a ridiculous amount of money to entertain us.
Especially like those guys too.
Yeah, I mean football players and basketball players, even baseball's getting that now.
Baseball's
dude, like they get paid a ridiculous amount of money. Now, yeah, you're an athlete. You have a talent. You're a God gifted talent to this world. But
I mean, you deserve the money.
You deserve the money. But
absolutely,
I kind of like support them using their own money to fund their own league.
Like, I'm just like, what do you? But
that's kind of like.
But what are you boycotting? Because
if you're boycotting COVID, I'm down.
No, but hear me out here. Because the NBA sent out like a 100-plus page memo to all the teams about all the new rules and regulations. Some of them,
it's like the moral.
You can't play card. Like when you play cards, you have to throw the deck away.
Wait, what?
After each use.
This is part of them.
This
like,
is
in
part
the,
of the fucking.
This is part
this
of
is
them
memo.
In the room.
This is the memo that okay. they got sent. So stuff like that, you can't play doubles ping pong. That's not allowed. But wait.
Wait, what's wrong with doubles ping pong?
That you're standing too close to each other. I don't know. But you can play basketball like right next to each other. I don't know, dude. It doesn't make sense.
Like how are you going to get up in someone's face on the court and block someone? Like
how are you just about to just like fucking stuff someone's face? Like get that shit out of my house. Okay, but hey, but if you're playing ping pong, no.
You can't Forrest Gump it.
But this is the best part though, is that they are recreational drug use
is approved
is being for the rest of the 2020 season.
Now what kind of recreational drugs?
So like marijuana?
Yeah, but what about like heroin and crack?
I don't think that's recreational. Is it
mushrooms? Like can the players like go play on mushrooms?
No, but
it's like full on Space Jam real life. But, these guys are just
they're just tripping balls. They're just like,
Bugs Bunny just keeps spiking me in the corner.
Yeah, they're just like, what the fuck? So, But recreational drug testing is being postponed the rest of the 2020 season. So these dudes are about to be in Disney World
stoned.
Straight blasted.
Stoned.
These dudes are about to be buckled. Like, you're going to get a contact high if you're staying in this hotel.
How dope, though. Like, literally.
They're going to, dude. Like,
the games are going to be so much fun because they're going to be like, they're going to be so high in the game. They're going to be dribbling. They're like, hold on, what are we doing, man? Yeah. Get over here, man.
Yeah, but I thought that was pretty wild. So that's what I'm saying. Why are you trying to boycott the season? Because you got it pretty good.
Yeah, you get to have fun.
They're still enforcing the performance-enhancing drug testing. You can't be doing that.
See, that's where...
But go ahead and smoke the shit out of some weed.
So this is where I'm thinking baseball. No fans. No one's in the stadium. Bring back steroids.
Dude, right? And just let them go to, like...
Steroids and aluminum bats.
Yeah, and just let them just roid rage each other, like...
Just put a bullet...
And allow fighting.
Yeah, put a bulletproof fence, like, in front of the pitcher. That way he doesn't take a 300-mile-an-hour fastball to the dome.
That way he just doesn't take his head clean off with a baseball.
Yeah, like, we'll give some... Like, that's the only... I mean, God, could you imagine being shortstop and just a zinger coming at you with an aluminum bat? Thing!
Dude, could you imagine, like, one of those dudes just... Like Mike Trout just roided beyond belief.
With an aluminum bat just sitting there like, what is it?
He's over there like...
Rookie of the year, tongues out. Just like,
yeah,
that guy is
just like... yeah, that would just be them on every pitch. Actually, just give them a pitching machine as well.
No, let the pitcher stay.
No, I'm saying give them a pitching machine and just like watch the scores be like 73 to fucking... to 82. You're like, what?
But I agree with you.
Just a home run every hit. Just Mike Trout. Just he's on deck doing practice swings, and then he just like bends the bat in half because he's just roided out of his face.
Just zits all over him. Yeah. Just acne. Like
he's just like walking around. Like
halfway through the season, switch it to estrogen.
Ooh, little turnaround, huh? No, but did you hear about all the baseball stuff too? Like
they're like. They're talking about like just completely not doing the season.
Well, no,
because they can't agree on anywhere to play.
Because also the owners wanted like a 60 game
season. Yeah,
and the players were like, we want more money. So they're like, we're gonna do a 70 game season, and there's like $50 million worth of like bonuses for like playoffs and stuff. So like the players are gonna get paid.
But aren't they already on like predetermined contracts so that you're getting made X amount of money per year?
Yeah, I don't know all the details.
So every other industry you work in, take my industry. If you're a pilot, you're making $250,000 a year, then you had an owner that decided to keep you on, and you usually flew 8 to 10 days a month, and then the last 4 months you've been on vacation. No flying. Checking with the owner, he's like, yep, we ain't going nowhere.
4 month vacation doesn't sound too bad, though.
Right? But how am I about to go back to my owner when he wants to fly again? Be like, hey, bro, I need another $50,000 on top of that.
Hey.
I know we're going to even work less than we normally do, but I want an extra 50.
But I'm going to need more.
I mean, what's a regular baseball season? 160 games, right?
I don't know. They play a shit ton of games.
I'm horrible with like team sports and knowledge and shit. So like,
I don't... Yeah, they play a ton of games.
It's like 160.
But they're talking about doing 70 games in like 60 something days.
I mean, that's a lot. So 162 games is a normal season. So
that's
you're
a ton of
so
games.
You've already had, let's see, season starts in April. So you're 2.5 months off the season right now. And you're going to go back to your boss and be like, "Hey, I know we're playing 100 less games, but I need more money."
But I'm going to need that contract in full, baby.
No, I'm sorry. You guys are... I respect you guys for your God-gifted talent. But hey, what about... This is where I'd support you guys, 100%. That was loud and annoying. This is where I'd support athletes doing this. If an athlete 100% was like, hey, we want somehow to get more money, but every bit of this, we're going to donate to a fund like supporting Wounded Warriors or like supporting cancer or something like that. Like... Where they're going to return that money back and do something good with it toward charity, I would be all about them asking for more money. I think that would be dope. Like, if they turned it around and wanted to help the community, I'd back it 100%, 110%. Like, if I could tell my...
Fair enough.
If I can go to work and tell my boss, like, hey, I want... We work for billionaires when we fly. And so, like, if I was able to tell my boss...
Hey, you love that humble brag, huh? No, just, but I work for billionaires with a B, no, bitch.
But when you fly corporate aviation, you're flying multimillionaires, billionaires, and stuff like that. So, like, if you could approach your boss one day and be like, hey, I want you to double my salary, but the double half of that salary, I want to put this towards a foundation. Like, you're able to, like, take a portion of your salary and donate it. 100%. All proceeds.
You're such a nice guy.
But that would make more sense. Like,
that's because you haven't made millions of dollars and you don't own a mansion and don't have a Ferrari, you fucking loser.
Well, let's make sure we start making millions of dollars so I can own a Ferrari and a mansion.
Right, and then I want to see where you're at when you come back and you're like, yeah, I want to donate it. You're like, yeah, right, give me that cash, bitch.
I'm Rick James.
Yeah, I'm Rick James, bitch. Give me my full contract for 60 games. Mm-mm.
See... That's the problem with me. I think anyone that's ever known me when I was making good money realized I'm the worst with money because I'm the guy that loves to buy the party.
You literally are the worst with money. Not in like a bad way. Like, you just, you spend it on shit you don't need, first off.
What do you see in this room right now that I don't need?
All of it.
Okay. Anyways.
All of that.
I mean, well, I use that to work out with.
Barely.
Worked out this morning.
You, whoa.
Hour workout.
Whoa.
I use that to do sick tricks on.
You don't even ride a bike anymore.
It's sitting right there upside down.
Yeah, sitting there. Yep.
I rode the other day with you.
Not on that bike.
I use that to do really cool stuff on.
I think I've literally seen you use that like 3 times since I've known you.
Okay. Well, I use these all the time.
I mean, I'll give you, you use them. I wouldn't say all the time.
And I let other people use them.
See, and there we go. That brings us right back to the point that I was making. You're terrible with your money because you just spend it on shit you don't need and basically just use it to have other people come hang out.
Yeah. It's kind of fun.
It's all right.
I like supplying the party.
It's all right. But yeah. Oh, also, if we're still talking about sports here, you want to hear who's making out on all this? The NHL players, baby.
Oh, yeah.
Did you hear about, because they have like hub cities that certain teams are. Dude, some of the guys are going to be stuck in Vegas. You're stoked.
Right?
It's like, because shit's opening back up there.
Yeah, right? No, Vegas is dope. They're like. Back and running again.
So, like, dude, are you going to... Dude, these guys going to go play a game with no crowd? So, like... I mean, are they even going to be really worried about, like, the game?
Right.
And then you're just going to go rage it in Vegas?
Well, that's what I was saying. Like,
there's going to be so much cocaine being done. Oh, my God. So much coke.
Especially with hockey players.
Oh, God.
We all know hockey players.
They love coke.
I was one growing up. I didn't do coke, for
Liar.
The record.
Liar.
I drank the beer. I love the beer. But, man, like what you said earlier, though, like especially in these environments right now, all sports fighting 100% legal. Every sport.
Right?
Fights.
Let it go.
Let's just not let hockey be the one awesome sport left in the world. Let's make sure that everyone gets a chance to fight.
That was really loud. What is that?
I know exactly what that is right now. But,
We might have to pause this and,
No, we're going
to
keep talking.
Oh, we're going to keep going?
Yeah.
All right, cool. nothing to worry about here, folks.
We can edit this down. Fuck, Jesus. I don't get, like, any service in here, though.
Yeah, we'll start this over. Start from the beginning where you started here. Cut.
She's in the shower.
Yeah, that's really loud.
Yeah, she's for sure in the shower.
Yeah.
See, the way our studio's set up here, It's not that we're like in a hole, but
we're kind of in a hole.
We're kind of in a hole. Hey, balling on a budget.
Oh,
I think we're good.
I think we're good now. Okay, so redo.
So, like, we can't let hockey be the only rad sport out there. Like, hockey's a man sport. You play hockey, like,
well, there's some badass motherfuckers.
You're a tough son of a
gun.
You're a tough son of a biscuit.
You're gosh darn tough.
You're tough son gun. You tough son good.
Right.
I think we need to allow. I mean, soccer players, they know how to fake getting hurt. Like, let's let soccer players like be their fans, because I'll give it to soccer fans. Soccer fans are like the gnarliest, violent, most violent, angry people.
Right, they are beating the hell out of each other.
Those hooligans can fight, dude.
They're throwing smoke bombs, fucking got baseball bats, horns in each other's fucking eyelids.
Oh, they're rad. I'll give it to like soccer fans, most rad fans out there. Like, those fans are sick. They know how to get their team riled
up. I'll give you that. I'll give you that for sure.
So let's take like soccer.
Not a big soccer fan though, for the record.
Yeah, I've been to games in Europe and they're so fun. Like, but it blows your mind, cuz like you'll be at a game and the team's winning and they're pissed off. And then their team's losing and they're still pissed. You're like, "Where, how do you guys get happy? Like, where's the happy come from in this one?"
I'm confused.
They're just sitting there like, "See that guy third row down there? I'm going to beat the hell out of him after the game."
Love it.
Following that guy out with a baseball bat. How dare he looks at us like that and wears those colors.
Yeah, how dare he wears those colors that aren't our team.
Dopest gangs ever.
Love it.
Soccer hooligans. Green Street Hooligans. Great movie.
And then there's just, you know, the guys actually out on the field flopping around like a fucking fish when they stub their pinky toe.
When someone hit their shoelace.
Meanwhile, this dude's fucking 8 beers deep up in row 347, can barely even see the field.
47 lines of cocaine deep.
But he is throwing haymakers.
He can't feel his face if someone showed it to him. That was a horrible analogy. Wow. Not always good off the top of my head. Man.
Did you say he can't feel his face if someone showed it to him?
Mm-hmm. Hey,
I'm still trying.
Look at your face.
I'm still trying to put this one together.
Oh, my face!
Can't feel my face if someone showed it to him.
Yeah, I don't know what I was. He couldn't feel his face if.
Yeah, you got nothing, huh?
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, we're gonna. We're just going to veer away from that one.
What would you say? Like, that guy that's 30 beers deep and 20 lines of cocaine, he can't feel his face like what?
Like a paraplegic can't feel his...
Oh, wow. We have paralyzed friends, dude. Sorry, Jake. Sorry, Travis. We love you. Well, Devin might not. I care for my paralyzed... You don't care for your paralyzed friend. You used to let Jake flop around in the gym on the floor without helping him up and videotape him and put it on the internet.
That's true. I don't deny that statement at all.
I've seen how you treat Jacob. I mean, honestly, he should quit being so lazy and get up on himself.
I mean, that's what, you know.
Hey, you can't teach him if you give him everything in
life,
right?
If you're going to stand here and tell me that if one of your best friends was in a wheelchair, and he fell, that you're not going to point and laugh and film it and then say, "Hey, are you okay?" You know? Like, I made sure he was fine, like, after I got my laughs out. And, like, we're like, "What the fuck you doing, you idiot? Get off the ground, dummy."
See, that's why I like Devin.
But
this is why I love Devin.
I then helped him up.
He doesn't discriminate.
Nah.
He doesn't care if you're smart, stupid, or paralyzed. You get treated the same way.
Same way. Like, if you fell out of a fucking random chair and fell on the ground, I'm not helping you up.
No, you'd probably laugh at me.
I'm laughing at you, filming it.
But I'm also not.
And if you're continuing to lay on the ground, then I'm going to be like, "Hey, all right?" Like, you good? And then when you're like, "Yeah, my ego's just hurt," I'd be like, "Yeah, I'm not helping you up."
The best part is that, like, we have... so many videos of your dad videoing you crashing, and every time you crash, you just hear your dad, "God, please don't get hurt."
Oh, he's like, "Oh, God, please don't be dead. Please, God." Yeah, well, apparently he cares a little bit more than I do. Loser.
He just cares about his son.
What are you, a freaking loser?
But what's up with like the sensitivity of people? Like, why are we changing the name of syrup?
I don't even know, dude.
How all of a sudden is Aunt Jemima 200 years later offensive?
I don't know, but I saw a video of a guy eating pancakes with that. And he's like, dude, I had no idea that this was right. Like, I had no idea. Hold on. Let me try these pancakes real quick. And then he like cuts them up and he puts the syrup on it. And he takes a bite and then he's like, oh, yep. Yep, I can taste the racism in there. And I'm like, dude, that's the shit that I'm like, you get it, sir. You, sir, get it.
Did you see the one where they were going to rename Aunt Jemima to Motherfucker with just Samuel L. Jackson's face on the front of it?
Oh, God, yes.
That's some good motherfucking syrup. Hey, pass me some of that motherfucker.
Pass me some of that motherfucking syrup. Dude, you gotta respect, like...
But what about Cracker Jacks, dude? They're now Caucasian Jacks.
Ooh. Yeah. There's too much offensive stuff out there nowadays.
When's this whole political correctness going to fucking end and we go back to being... Sorry for saying the F word. When's this political correctness going to end and we just go back to being normal humans and... Like, how... Dude, think about your life... 6 years ago, were you offended when you went to a Waffle House and they brought out Aunt Jemima's?
Yep.
Man.
Yep.
So it was like Southern chicken, fried chicken offensive?
Yep.
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 Shit.
Yep. Still offensive. Still offended.
Man.
Offended right now. Fact that you're even asking me the question. I'm offended. Fuck out of my face. I'm offended. Triggered. Get out of my face.
Can we send all the triggered people to their own?
Can I just?
Oh, who was that?
Can I just go over your search history that says mermaid alcohol?
Oh, that's not mine. I have a sister.
What does that mean, though? What
I don't
is
know.
Mermaid
I
alcohol?
I have a sister that uses my computer. Maybe she was looking for a label with a mermaid on it. That's what it is.
Okay.
Dude, actually, I found one that I support today. I got to look at my phone for this because I fully support this guy. I hope it's true. I haven't fact checked it. But sometimes you just don't got it. When shit's funny enough, you just don't fact check it. You just laugh at it like normal people. Everyone's
I'm offended that you're laughing at that.
Every single day.
I'm triggered.
Every single day on Facebook, I get, your post has been taken down by an independent fact checker. Oh, so everyone's just all of a sudden a fact checker today? Fact checker. Like, how do I get that role? Like, how do I get... What do you do in life? I am a fact checker on the internet. Excuse me?
I Google
everything
facts on the internet.
How do you know what you Google is true?
Because Google told me. And everything on the internet is true.
You can't believe everything on the internet.
Nope. Google put it out there. It's real.
Man.
That's all there is to it.
We need better Wi-Fi in this house.
Yeah. I'm sitting here stalling for you, trying to give you enough time, and you're just fucking blowing it.
Little flacking on my phone over here.
Jesus.
So it was an athlete, and he talked about how he, because like, there's been all these celebrities out there that have raised like $200 million in bonds for like people to get out of jail that protested. It's like, that's sick, but why don't you use that $200 million to help your community? Why don't you use that $200 million to like help the business that just got destroyed in the looting? Why don't you use that $200 million to help people? Why are we letting the people out of jail that went to jail for breaking the law? Like, that doesn't make any sense. And then from there, this one football player, I don't know if he was a football player.
doesn't even know what he is.
No, I think he was a football. Yeah. Yeah, he's a running back. Herschel Walker, he offers to partner with the airlines to send people to countries that don't like our laws and don't like our police anymore. I thought that was awesome. Herschel Walker, look him up. NFL running back.
Wait, so he's...
He's saying he's going to partner with the airlines.
So he's going to like pay for people's tickets to leave?
Yeah. You don't like it here? You don't like our government? You don't like our laws? We'll send you somewhere else where they don't have those laws. We'll send you smack dab in the middle of Somalia. They're going to love your ass.
Hey.
You ever been raped by a Somalian pirate?
Oh, God.
We're going to send you over to...
No,
we're going to send you over to Libya. You saw what they did to Gaddafi.
A couple of fingers in the butt.
And a knife.
Oh. Pennsylvania.
I'm gonna say though, that's kind of cool though.
I back that 110%. You don't like cool. You don't like it here, leave.
But it's like, that's a respectable way of doing it though.
But finally, like someone like.
Because like I feel like a ton of people are those people that are like, oh, like, you know, this place sucks. These rules suck. Blah blah. And they're like, oh, I wish I just could move somewhere. And you're like, well, here's your chance.
We got you.
Here's your chance.
We're sending you a nice.
Quit talking about it. Be about it.
Right here. Got it on my computer.
Quit talking about it. Be about it.
Start doing. Stop talking. Doing's greater than talking. Live it. All right?
A wise man once told me, quit philosophizing.
Quit philosophizing.
Quit philosophizing.
We got a nice one-way ticket to you to a sandbox. It gets 137 degrees in the summertime. Not a lot of water. Very restricted government. Gas is their own people. Great time. Enjoy.
Wow.
Like, I'm down. Like, let's just see, you know, let's just partner with the military. C-17, just pack them in there like a pack of sardines. Get them all 6 inches from each other.
You're getting dark on this one.
Put some, you know what? Even better. Let's go XXX on them. Give them a bunch of static line parachutes. Drop the cargo door. A little nice little steep climb. Let them all roll out the back. Tumbling into each other in the air as they parachute into their new home in the desert.
Wow.
I should write movies.
That sounded like a Transformers scene.
Michael Bay.
Michael Bay is sick.
These are some people falling out of the sky.
But how about that too, man? Like, all of a sudden, like, all these police movies are all of a sudden offensive. The show Cops is all of a sudden offensive. It's like everyone that's ever played a cop, every actor, you now have to like take back that stance on when you played a good cop in a movie because that portrayed police wrong. I'm sick of it.
Yeah, we're all sick of it. Moving on to something a little bit funnier, though, huh?
I think you just said it best, though. Like, let's cut the bullshit, because either way, you're wrong, no matter what side you're on anymore.
Dude, you can't win. It's like, even if you're, you know...
So let's all agree that we're all going to lose and go back to normal.
Or let's just all agree that, like, hey, we're all cool people.
Yeah.
There's a few bad ones out there, but, like...
Let's agree what liberty is.
Most people are fucking cool and, you know... We like to hang out with them.
Exactly. But, like, why does everything have to be wrong? There's no conversation anymore. Let's just drop it all. Let's drop all that and go back to what liberty is. No oppression. And we have the right to believe whatever we want to believe, no matter what our gender is.
Well, that's you still have the right to believe whatever you want to believe, but people don't enjoy your opinion anymore.
Don't be an asshole and stand so damn stuck to your opinion.
That's why I just let people think whatever the fuck they want to think, because it's like, who cares? It's an opinion for a reason. I can disagree with it.
Grow up, people.
I can agree with it. Yeah. I can not care about it as well.
Were you offended by someone? What someone said today? Go find your mom and cry to your mom.
Wow, you're so angry. All right.
You don't have a mom, go cry to a waterfall.
Well, I'm gonna bring the mood up a little bit. Because that just got sad and dark.
A little dark.
And this one actually can tie into this.
Okay.
So a man named Daniel Thorson.
Daniel Thorson.
Emerged from a 75-day silent retreat as part of a Buddhist community in Vermont and comes back with a tweet. Hey, was gone for 75 days in silence. Did I miss anything? This is real. This happened.
You know that happened with Jared Leto?
But yeah, I know. But Jared this guy has been completely silent away from the world for 75 days. And then he just comes back with, hey, did I miss anything?
Not much.
Yeah, so the world's just fucking on fire.
How do you explain this? One minute, go. Explain what happened in 1 minute. If you met this guy and he said, what did I miss? You get 1 minute to tell him everything that's going on.
I would literally just say, the world's on fire. That's all I need to tell you.
And he says, why?
He's like, what do you mean? There's just a crazy pandemic. A bunch of people hate each other now.
Race war broke out.
You know, just...
Murder horns got unleashed on the world.
You didn't miss too much, I would say. nothing too crazy.
Do you imagine coming back to your city and you're just like, what the? You go back to Minneapolis, you're right. Like, whoa.
Yeah, he's coming back all like, hey, how's it going, Frank? Shut up, you pussy. What?
Whoa.
What? I'm sorry, what? You okay? No, eat a dick. Oh, my God. What the? What is going on? Oh, my God. Wear a mask, fucking loser. What? I'm confused. For what?
For being an idiot and leaving. But, dude, that happened. So Jared Leto legitimately has a cult going right now out in the Mojave Desert in California.
Mojave.
Yeah. So he's got this whole cult, and it's a festival if you look it up online, and you could pay to go to this festival and stuff. They were in, like, when COVID broke out, they were, like, in, like, a 45-day meditation. They came out, like, 3 weeks into COVID, and they had no idea. They said they've been away from the world and away from technology that they had no idea.
What do you do for 45 days in a meditation?
You learn about yourself.
And by meditation...
And everyone has to wear white, and you sleep in ertz. But they have different levels of sleeping. Like, there's, like, different packages you can get out there. You can spend up to $500 to be part of this cult. I don't want to spend money to join a cult.
I'm just still trying to figure out what the hell 45 days of meditation is like. Because I can't even sit still for like 3.5 minutes.
Yeah, you're pretty bad.
Well, I'm just going to sit there and be like, can I do something now? Like, can I like... You know, ride my bike or like go to the gym or like do something with my life. Because sitting here and just
I can ride my bike with no handlebars.
You know what I mean? No, like how do you do that? Like that's crazy. And by meditation for 45 days, do they just mean they did a ton of shrooms and acid and just kind of tripped out for 45 days?
Yeah, they just did a psychedelic trip.
See,
that's different.
Tell me that though, because then I'm like.
I can't say if they did it because I don't know if they actually did like a press conference where like, yeah, so we just dropped a bunch of Molly and man, the world's just freaking crazy, huh, man?
Yeah, so our deluxe package includes meth, heroin, weed, mushrooms, and ecstasy, all for $500 a night. Well, that's not a bad deal. For 45 days, let's get weird.
Just tripping balls for 45 days. Could you imagine? Like, just coming out of that, and you're like, man. Like, coming out, could you imagine? Because there's like a bunch of people out there that love it. They love psychedelics. And, you know, that's your deal. You guys love it. It'd probably scare the hell out of me, but, like, you just come out of this, like, all enlightened, and you're feeling good about yourself. You're like,
yeah, man, I've got it all figured out.
And you walk out, and the world's just on fire. Like, what the f-? My third eye did not tell me that.
You're like, can we go back and can we go back and do another round of 45 days? Because this shit sucks.
You just see him go like, they come out. There's like, they're like coming out of the freeway in their car like, duh, yeah. They're like pulling into LA and they're like, little pill bag.
They're like, yeah, let's throw this bitch in reverse. Heading back to the desert to go get weird again.
I'm going to just go back.
Yeah.
I mean, that's. I'm thinking like right now, like to be part of a monastery would be pretty dope probably. Like the old monks monastery, like they just have no idea. They're just like sitting.
Like Doctor Strange. Like yeah. You're just fucking learning some weird fucking hand motions.
You're just sitting out there in silence. Could you imagine like living in a monk monastery? Just like waking up every morning. And you don't even sign each other. You just like walk by each other. And you don't
hey,
even
can you stop? I'm casting a spell right now. All right? I'm a monk. Okay.
That would be yours. You would get kicked out of the monastery.
What?
I could see you doing this.
No, I'd be monk of the month.
Because you would just, like, everyone would be in silence and peaceful, and you're just walking around. You're like.
Wait, whoa. Are you just going to walk by the fact that I said I'm going to be monk of the month? Monk of the month.
Monk of the month.
That's a monk joke. People didn't know you could make monk jokes.
I can just see you flipping everyone off. Like you wake up in the morning, you're supposed to be like sworn to silence, and you walk outside. And you're like, hey, what's up, Bill?
What's up, pussies?
You walk out. And you're like, hey, Juan, how's it going? I said fucking hi.
Yeah. Oh, cool. You disrespectful asshole.
Cool. You cool guide me. I get it. Yeah. Cool guide me.
Whatever, you bald-headed loser. Fuck out of my face.
Curly-headed fuck.
We don't have hair. We're monks. What else do I got? What else do I got written down here? Oh, this one, dude. This one was sweet. So, a 100-year-old giant Galapagos tortoise.
Okay.
Is retiring.
Excuse me?
He's retiring. For go ahead, ask me for what?
Is he going back in the shell?
No. Go ahead. Ask me what he's retiring
What's
from.
What's he retiring
he's
from?
He's retiring from laying so much goddamn pipe. This dude, for 50 years, single-handedly increased the tortoise population by 40%. This dude was railing.
Hold on. Who called his retirement?
I don't know. I don't know if he was just like, hey, I've had enough. I want to settle down.
Like, turtles don't.
Or if they were like,
well, I guess turtles...
bro, let the other guys have some.
Crush is just coming. He's like, dude, that chick was hot, man.
He's like, fuck.
Totally.
No, but.
Sweet.
When he was like 50 years ago, there were only 2 males and 12 female turtles. Tortoises, sorry. Whoa, for all the turtle people out there.
Oh, that would be Crush. So yeah. These are tortoises. These are different. Yeah, these are land-based turtles.
Yeah. But so there was 2 males, 12 female tortoises. This dude single-handedly brought that shit up to 2,000.
That dude.
This dude is just climbing on shell and just. For all of you that don't know what fucking turtles sound like when they're boning down, look that up because that's what they sound like.
So basically, there was 2 males. There was Johnny Fuckboy, and then there was me.
Yeah.
And I was just like, I'm sitting there talking to Johnny Fuckboy, and he's like Alex trying to like pump me up in the crowd. He's like, dude, you got this. Dude, look at, she totally digs
you,
bro.
Chick's into you.
She's into you. All right, I got this. All right, here I go. Oh, dude, she said she reminded me of her brother. He died like 7 years ago.
Damn. Fuck. She said your shell reminds me of my brother.
And then fuckboy Johnny just walks in there. He's like,
dude, no worries. You know, I want to talk to her anyways. What's
like,
up?
He walks in. He's like, oh, your brother died? Oh, that's so bad.
Oh, my God.
He's like, man, turtle funerals, best badge out there.
Best turtle badge ever. Yeah, but fucking good for him, though. No, but...
Like, do they have, like, turtle wedding crashers? Like, that dude was just, like, the Chaz of wedding crashing?
Dude, I don't know, but that guy's lived a life, man.
Could you imagine just his stories? Like, that guy's just like, yeah, so I was just, down in one girl one night.
Yeah, back in, like, 72, I think it was, man, I was chowing on some lettuce this one time, man, and I don't know what was in that lettuce, but I was feeling a little weird. Next thing I know, I got 3 other chick tortoises, dude, and next thing I know, I'm just, all night. Good for you. His name was Diego, by the way.
Diego. The tortoise has a name?
Yeah, his name was Diego.
Well, that makes...
Long Dick Diego.
Long Dick Diego. All the girls in the tortoise tribe were like, oh, you know Diamond Dick Diego?
Oh, you saw Diego last night?
Did he slay you too?
Did he give you that?
Or did he give you that?
Or was he back there just...
And you know, there was always that like one tortoise that Diego just wasn't into, and he's just like laying there on the back of his shell. He's like, all right, get it over with. Come on.
I know. He's like, Jesus Christ. All right.
He's like sitting there.
He's like, I'm only doing this to increase the population. You know that, right?
He's
I'm like, going to like you.
He's like sitting over there. He's like, yeah, Tiffany over there. She's bad. Oh, yeah. Hey, can you hurry up, Karen?
Yeah.
I got a date with Tiffany in a second.
Karen's like, it's fine. You can imagine it's Tiffany. You can close your eyes and just, you know, if that helps.
He's like, feed me some lettuce.
I know. He's like... He's like, let's get this over with. It's so, fine if you think I'm Becky. It's cool. You can close your eyes and just, you know, it's cool.
It's Jules. Yeah. He's like, I got Jules, Becky, and Tiffany just sitting in the corner
lined
right now.
Lined up. Let's go.
Hurry up.
That's pretty wild, though. That guy straight put 2,000 tortoises on this planet himself.
Do tortoises get endurance over time? Like, after they start having a lot of sex, do they like they just like can't get it off anymore? And they're just
I don't know. They had
doing
to be
all sorts of kinky
dude.
Stuff.
At that point, the fucking the scientists that were watching this guy were just crushing up Viagra and putting it in its fucking lettuce. It had to have been way. This turtle's just fucking railing like that.
But what do tortoises live for? They live for like 200 years, right?
Yeah, they're old. This one's 100.
He's in his prime still. Why is he calling it? Why is he calling it?
Because when you put 40% of the tortoise population on this planet single-dickedly.
Like, one scientist is telling him, hey, Diego, you can't dick any more turtles down, by the way. He's like, dude, come on, like, three more. Let me get three more.
That's why I'm saying, like, I don't know if he made the call or if the scientists were like, hey, we got a couple other males now. They need, you know, they need their time to shine. Step down.
Do you think he's going to do, like, a comeback story and, like, start giving lessons to the
early guys?
He's
probably going to write a book. He's probably going to write a book on, like, his just crazy tortoise fuck fest experience.
Dick Adventures with Diego.
Yeah. Fucking.
Chapter one.
Fucking to Save the World by Diego the Tortoise.
And one dick saved them all.
Yeah. And if you don't think that that was on my mind, that I was saving the turtle community one dick at a time, you're dead ass wrong.
Oh, there's pictures of him.
Of Diego? Oh, look at him. No wonder he was pulling so much fucking...
Look at that neck! Man.
We're talking about his actual neck, yeah, you know, just to clarify.
Look at that. Oh, look at that mouth, man. He got a pretty mouth.
Yeah.
You can see why the girls liked him.
No wonder.
He's just got that, hey, what up, baby?
That is a sexy-ass tortoise. God damn.
You know that.
Look at this one. Look at that. Oh, look at that fucking... Woo!
He's just stunting out there.
Straight up.
I mean, Diego the... Ooh.
Dioga?
Dioga. Diego, look at this one. He's kind of like... This one, he just... Like, he's going into retirement. That's how they knew he was retired. That's the retirement
that
photo.
That is a picture, basically, what his penis looks like, because it's just so tired.
Look at
the fuck? Dude, in between the shell looks like a nut sack. Tell me that does not look like a ball sack.
He's all like stretched.
Tell me
up.
Right now that does not look like a fucking shaved pair of nuts.
If you guys can't see what we're looking at, just go ahead and type in Diego the Tortoise. And just look at these photos, man. This guy's a savage.
And tell me that Diego's...
Oh, look at that. That's the look. You know, that's the look right there.
Tell me Diego's whole body doesn't look like a nut sack.
That's the look he gave the women right there. Ooh, look, he's got that like bottom lip bite.
He's like, just like walking around. He's like, who the fuck wants some?
Look at that lip bite there. He's like, you're mine.
Who's catching this turtle dick tonight? Who wants some of this long turtle dick tonight?
God, though, could you imagine? Oh, there he is in action. There's an action shot of Diego.
Oh, my God, there's a leaked Diego sex tape. Oh, there's a leaked Diego sex tape.
Come on, come on.
Oh, come on. Fuck. Might already been taken down. His lawyers were all over it.
The Kim Kardashians. Yeah. Oh, we can't say that. That's going to give us a lawsuit.
Yeah, you can't say that.
Just Another Failure podcast gets sued by the Kardashians. They took their wallpaper.
Fuck. It was like $6 off Amazon.
But man, there's a photo.
Just kidding. This is real wood. That's mahogany behind us.
Oh, look, he's about to get it on. Look at, there's like a whole snapshot scene of them. Like, there he is. Like, meet. Oh, hold on. Hold on.
Jesus Christ.
Oh,
what's happening?
There's like a snapshot scene of them missing each. Oh my gosh. Snapshot scene of them checking each other out. And then he's got. Oh, there he mounted her.
Oh.
Wow.
Diego, you dirty dog. Oh.
Man.
Oh, Diego. Wow.
Wow, bud. You're a legend, bud.
Fuck. This is the Ron Jeremy of tortoises.
Look at his neck, though. I mean, he's got to have a package with a neck like that. How many followers do you think we just lost about having 10 minutes of turtle talk sex?
I mean, if you're not into Diego fucking repopulating the turtle community, we don't want you. We don't even want you as a follower.
I don't even want you here anymore. Yeah. If you don't get turtle sex humor and think it's funny, look at, there's all his kids.
Damn, look at him.
Oh, look, he's cute.
He's such a good dad, too.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, what do you think his alimony checks are?
I don't know.
Do you think, like, what would a Jerry Springer episode be like with Diego and all his wives?
Like, Diego, it's physically impossible for you not to be the father. I don't even know why you're on this show.
This is
really
bull crap, man.
No way, dude. No way.
Talk to the scientist.
There's physically no way. You literally had sex with every female turtle in this establishment.
He goes to run out of there. He's like, no. I didn't do it. That's not mine.
There's just a camera strapped to one of the other turtles following him.
He's running, guys.
Wow, honestly, this is way better than Jerry because it's like it's really slow, so I can keep focused on it.
There's a bouncer that just like stands in front of him. Get out of my way! Get out of my way!
Just starts riding them.
They're like, oh, he's about to juke him out. Oh, hold on. He's about to make a move.
Oh,
broke his ankle.
You guys are going to have to get an imagination to figure out what we're talking about. If you can't picture that one, your brain sucks.
I think they should get it.
Wow. Yeah, I just wonder who called his retirement. Like, did he just call him up one morning and, like, turtles could talk? Oh, I guess turtles talk. I've been to Disneyland. I've talked to Crush a ton. So I guess, I guarantee a tortoise can. If a turtle can, a tortoise can.
That's a cartoon, though.
What do you think? Do you think he sounds like Crush, though? Like, Crush is like a surfer, gnarly dude.
This guy's
like a desert pirate. Like,
I see Diego being like a pretty cool cat.
Like, he just calls him up and he's like, hey, guys. Yeah, dude, Dick's just not doing it anymore. Yeah. I'm done.
He's like, hey, what's up? It's Diego. Yeah, we know who you are, Diego. Yeah.
He just has that presence that speaks for himself.
Yeah.
He doesn't even have to say his name. He just picks up the phone. He's like, hey, guys. Like, Diego, how's it going, man?
Oh,
how you doing?
Diego,
what's up?
What up?
Seriously, guys?
Oh, my God.
You have 2,000 kids, and this is how you get treated.
It's like, Jesus.
Seriously, get off my nuts, guys. I'm done.
Get off these turtle nuts.
These nuts.
Speaking of Crush, the cartoon character, I was thinking about this the other day.
No.
What?
What did you say? Crush what?
Cartoon?
He's real.
No, cartoon.
No. He is real.
Okay.
I talked to him on the hydrophone.
The hydrophone.
Anyways, go on with your stupid story.
No, there's no story. I was just saying, like, I was thinking about this the other day. And what was your favorite cartoon growing up? Like, what was your go-to? Because I kind of wanted to hear the different perspective here, because...
But we probably overlapped.
That's what I'm saying.
But
so,
like young, like young youngster me was like Rugrats and Doug and Hey Arnold. Like the
Rocket Power, baby.
Rocket Power was dope.
Rocket Power was the shit.
Rocket Power was sick because that was like the Southern California dope skater based.
That's what it was like, yeah, rad bikes and scooters and fucking.
I mean,
no one liked the rollerblading scenes, but it's whatever.
It's whatever.
They were trying to get action sports, but like, everyone knows that rollerblading.
But Rocket Power is dope.
No, Rocket Power was sick. I loved
and
Rocket
then, like,
Power.
I used to love, like, one Saturday morning, you'd have, like, recess and, like, the Wild Thornberries and stuff.
Yeah, all that.
I used to love the Wild Thornberries because you got Nigel Thornberry.
Nigel. Fucking Nigel Thornberry.
But, like, I think I came out of the womb with, like, a safari hat on and an astronaut helmet.
Really?
Yeah. Like, I was either going to be...
You came out like that.
Yeah, I was going to either go to space or I was just going to live in the jungle.
And you've done neither.
No, I've gone to the jungle. Amazon.
Nah.
Better than the Amazon jungle.
Nah, it's a rainforest.
It's a jungle.
Nah, rainforest. Rainforest cafe.
Been there.
No, you haven't.
Been to the safari. I've been to Tanzania. I've been to Kruger National
Shut
Park.
Shut up. We know. You fly. Fuck off. Jesus Christ.
But no, like, I think I grew up way too much on, like, Indiana Jones and Star Wars, and, like, it gave me the ultimate fast, like, fantasy life as a kid. I remember I was in high school, and I had a teacher in high school. And he told me I had too big of an imagination. It wasn't going to get me anywhere. Joke's on you, dickhead. I still haven't gotten anywhere.
Joke's on you, fuckface. I'm still nothing.
Fuck, damn it.
Maybe you were right.
All
right. Did you ever watch SpongeBob or were you past that?
SpongeBob was like a little late in the game for me. So like my little sister watched SpongeBob.
Okay. Because SpongeBob was like a big part of my childhood cartoonage.
Okay, did you just find out that SpongeBob came out as gay?
Yeah, what the actual fuck, man?
How is a sponge gay? No, alright, hold on. I have gay friends that literally are some
nothing,
of our best friends that are here.
Nothing against gay people at all.
No, seriously, they're here every night at our house, hanging out. Awesome people. And they were even like, he's a sponge.
Yeah, they're like, I'm confused.
They're like, it's confusing their own community. They're like, he's a sponge. Why is every... Like, and that's where, like, I was talking to them, and they're like, why does everything just have to get thrown in our community now? It's like, we're fine with us being us. Like, why does everything have to be us now?
I don't know. I just don't understand really, like, what did that do, though?
What's that prove?
Like, what does that put... Like, I don't know. It's just very weird for them to, like, come out and say,
hey, SpongeBob's gay.
Yeah, you're like,
You're like, what? Hold on.
Like, I'm what? Why? Why? For what reason is he? Why? Is like, this going to play into the story later?
Like, how it's going to get like some sick, nasty, like, backstory now. And, like, you're just going to come out and it's like, SpongeBob's a pedophile. And you're like, great.
You're like, wow. Okay.
Cool.
I actually, funny story about SpongeBob. I actually call him Spungbog.
Excuse me?
Spungbog.
Well, we all knew you can't talk.
No. This is because when I was a little youngin' in school.
You're still a little youngin'.
Well, I'm talking like wee little lad.
Wee little lad?
You had to like draw your favorite cartoon character. And I drew SpongeBob because he was my boy.
Yep.
And spelling still to this day, not my strong suit. And I spelled it out. Spongbog.
Spungbog.
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 And we were going through some old shit that my mom had the other day. We came across that picture. Dude, I lost it. First off, this drawing is horrifying.
No surprise.
Because it's just like, yeah, his teeth are like...
It's a square, dude. Oh, it's a square. What did you draw him, a triangle?
Oh, dude, I fucked this thing up.
How do you mess up SpongeBob?
I butchered SpongeBob, and then I just went ahead and just fucked his name up too, and went Spungbog.
What grade were you?
I don't know, like
freshman second in high school. Speaking of you and names, what about your audition?
What audition?
You know, the one that your mom tried to get you in a commercial.
Oh, the Geico commercial.
Yeah, how'd that go?
Yeah,
for you?
I tried to try to get the.
He's really good.
Well,
with names.
Well, so. First off, yeah, little backstory. This is when like the caveman commercials, like so easy a caveman could do it. I love those commercials.
And you had a beard in fifth grade.
Yeah, and so I was like, bro, I'm gonna be a little baby caveman. That's what this audition's for. Because I heard nothing about it. They were like, oh yeah, go try out for this audition. And I'm like, this is awesome. I'm gonna be a little mini caveman. My dreams are about to come true. And then I get there, and they're like, yeah, here's the lines you're reading. And it was like Rusty Wallace or something, I think. And he was like a go-kart driver. That's what I wanted to be. Yeah. I wanted to be a baby version of that guy. Oh, my God. I love it.
I love that there's a Neanderthal that just
lives
out there.
We need to put a picture of this that guy. Like just
the Geico caveman guy.
Geico caveman just right here. But, yeah, so they're like, oh, yeah, here's your lines. You're going to read this thing saying like, oh, I'm Rusty Wallace, blah blah, and so I'm nervous as hell.
Because what's an audition like?
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like, I'm already nervous as hell because I'm like, I've never done this before. I'm a young kid. I have no idea what's even going on. And then they call my name. And they're like, all right, you're up next. So I walk into this empty room with just a table and a camera pointed at me. And then like, there's three people at the table, and I'm like, they're like, what's your name? I'm like.
Da, 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 Johnny Walker.
Da, 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 Devin. Devin.
By the way, he's like 18 when he's doing this.
This is no, I had to have been like 11 maybe. And so I'm like, Devin. And like, all right, cool. Go ahead and read your line. And I'm like, I'm William Wallace. And they're like, yeah, no, that's not the guy's name. I'm like, what? They're like, you said William Wallace.
Take two.
I'm like, oh shit, that's the guy from Braveheart. My bad.
Scotland.
Yeah, I'm like
so close.
I'm like, all right.
I got this.
And then I'm like, oh, okay, focus. Start reading the line again. And then I'm like, yeah, you know, my name's William Wallace. And they're like, no, you fucking idiot. What did we just say? It's Rusty Wallace. Stop saying you're
William
not,
Wallace.
You're not from Braveheart.
He's like, next one, he's like, Sons of Scotland.
Yeah.
I am William Wallace.
I'm like, freedom.
I see a whole journey like, of my countrymen.
You're not even trying anymore. I'm like, yeah, I just wanted to be a caveman. Suck my dick.
You
I'm
didn't
out.
Say that.
No, I didn't.
I'm but, sorry.
But clearly, I didn't get the part because I just kept saying William Wallace instead of Rusty Wallace. So,
not bad. But auditions suck, dude.
Dude, auditions are tough.
We did good at our last one, though.
It's so awkward, though.
They are. But the fact how far you and I got in our last audition, that was a miracle. So
literally the day before, we're like, hey, you want to hit this audition?
Day before, Devin and I decided to be stuntman.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're trying out for a stuntman show.
Yeah, so we show up.
For whatever fucking reason.
Yeah, so we show up. We didn't really, you know, we had a buddy that's in it, so he kind of like...
Wait. let's give them a little story of what fueled us that day. What got us there at about 7 in the morning?
Bacon cheeseburger. That's right. Bacon cheeseburger, boy.
Dude, Matt scarfs down a bacon cheeseburger before a fucking audition. And we have zero idea what we're doing.
No idea.
And they're like, all right, we're going to start off with the physical part
portion of this
interview here.
So they break us up into groups. And so myself, Devin, and my sister and I, we're like group one. We're in group one. We're the test group. There's, what, 200 people at this audition?
There was a ton of people. That was a long day. Long 2 days.
Yeah, we're group one of this audition. And so we go in. Yeah, I just had a double bacon cheeseburger from this rad diner, by the way, in Santa Monica.
That place was sweet.
Or in Hollywood.
But they're like, oh, yeah, you know, we're going to have a circuit workout here just to see your physical abilities. Dude, I just look over at Matt, and he's like, oh, fuck. I'm like, bro. One is like, you got to, like, run a couple meters, drop down, do a push-up, run back, push-up, and back and forth. And then there was, like, pull-ups.
There was burpees.
What else was there?
Oh, there was box jumps.
Oh, yeah, box jumps. There was, like, that squat station,
too. There was a squat station.
Dude, we get through. We're, like, halfway through this thing, dude. I look over at Matt, and I can just smell bacon, like,
hey, but
coming out of every pore in his body.
But I killed it.
You made it.
Yeah. So I made it. So that's how we start our morning. Double cheeseburger.
I was having trouble breathing as well, just because I was laughing at you, just because you were trying to hold back a bacon cheeseburger from coming up.
Shitting my pants in the middle of it.
Oh, God. Matt, can you do a pull-up for us? Oh, God, there's a cheeseburger behind that.
One. Two. We need Pat here to do fart noises,
dude,
man.
Oh, my God. That was so funny, though.
But, yeah, so we Devin and I have zero... Devin, my sister, and I have zero... Well, he has a little acting experience. I had one tryout prior to this on a different show back in the day. We have, like, no, like, Hollywood background, nothing. And so we're, like, sitting there, and people are, like, coming up and talking to us. There's a lot of people there.
Dude, that was probably the best part of that whole experience, was watching all these people that do this, like, daily. Clearly, they go out to auditions and, like, try out for shit.
Mad respect to you guys, by the way.
Yeah, that is a horrible process to go through, like... Jesus.
Like, it was windier than Africa that morning.
But watching all these people, like, do their own weird little, like, things to get in the zone was just, like, me and Matt are just literally sitting in these two plastic chairs just staring at people going, what the fuck is that guy doing? What are you doing? What's he doing over there?
You see, like, people doing, like, yoga and, like, meditating and, like...
Dude, there's people doing full-on fucking
karate,
insane stretching.
Yeah, martial arts. Yeah. There's guys that are putting their toes over their head, and you're like, how the fuck, what?
You're like, what does that do for reading lines?
Devin and I are sitting there like, all right, well, I guess we'll just pick our nose and laugh at each other.
Yeah.
So we sit there. Round one of cuts happens, like, right around lunch.
Which we're already writing ourselves off.
Yeah, we're writing. We're like
there's
no way
we're going home.
They start reading the numbers, like, the callbacks, and all of a sudden, Devin are like, wait, bro, my number got called.
Did you get called?
You get called? Oh, shit. We just got called back. So all of a sudden, before that, though, we're, like, sitting there talking to people. And people are like, oh, how long have you guys been in acting? And we're literally sitting there. And we're like 10 minutes, I don't know, 2 hours or so. And they're like.
No, yeah. Well, no. What the guy asked us, though, he said something like, how long you guys, like, been doing stunts work?
Yeah.
And we're like, I don't know, like 5 minutes now. And he's like, oh, okay. Like, you guys are, like, actors. You're just trying out for the stunt thing. We're like.
They thought we were, like, old, crusty, like, actors that have been in the business for a while.
No, and that's what we, like, made the joke. We're like, no. And he's like, well, what do you mean? Like, you guys aren't actors or stuntmen. Like,
what are you doing here?
What do you do? And we're like, I don't know. We're just trying this out, like, seeing how it goes. And he's like,
thought it would be fun.
Yeah, and the guy goes, ah, that's funny. No, like, for real, what do you do? And we're like, no, seriously. This is our first time doing any of this. And he's like, what the fuck? Oh, I thought you guys were just being sarcastic, like, old crusty fucking dudes that were just pissed off. And we're like, no, seriously, we, like...
I fly airplanes and he rides bikes like an asshole.
We basically decided at 9 p.m. the night before to take our headshots. And then
go to Walgreens and print out our headshots and make a portfolio and resume.
And then at like 5 in the morning, we're like, hey, let's go drive to L.A. and try and do this fucking stash thing.
So Devin and I make round two. My sister didn't make it. She had a really good chance, but there was just so many girls, and they were only looking for one girl role, and there was a ton of, like, girl actors. I was really bummed. We were hoping to get all three of us, but like she was first time too. She just had a good time. And so like next day, Devin and I go back and we stop at the same diner.
What did Matt order?
Double bacon cheeseburger.
Round two, baby.
No, I didn't see this one coming. We show up around... Hold, please. Yeah, so day two, Devin and I show back up to the tryout. And I don't really think about a whole nother physical. So we go back to the same diner. Double bacon cheeseburger in the morning. I was like, eh, worked yesterday. Got to work today.
Worked yesterday.
So we show up. They call us all in the room together. So there's like, what was it? 50 of us day two, or like 75 of us day two. There was a lot of us.
There was still a ton of people there.
Like between like 50 and 75 of us day two, we show up. They bring us all back in like the gymnastics room, and there's like mats out. They start us out with like a 1 hour full on like workout, like kicks, rolls, tumbling, fighting.
And the doors were closed. The doors were closed.
It's like 116 in the room.
Dude.
Matt's double bacon cheeseburger, not so funny anymore.
Have you ever seen like literal bacon grease pour out of someone's forehead? Because that's what I was watching Matt do while he was trying to do a high kick and pulling his hammy.
Somehow, Devin and I made another cut.
Dude, and that was like, I want to know because our physical abilities are... I'll say, you know...
We're athletes. I mean, we can...
No,
we'll,
I'll say...
We'll play.
I'll say, like, I can manage to do some shit, but the fact that, like, there's people that have been on a show, on television, that we showed up and, like, they were like, you know what? These guys have a shot over someone that's already done this before. I was like, what the fuck kind of casting you guys got going here?
I thought we were all punked at this point. Like, I was waiting for just Ashton to, like, I thought they were just, like, kind of filming Devin and I separately, like,
well, we were
making
like,
fun of us.
We were, like, to the point, too, where we were like, dude, I kind of just want to go home now. Like, I'm fucking over this. Because it was like, dude, it's a long day. Like,
and
we
so
left our house at, like, 5 a.m.
And got home at, like, 10.
Yeah, like, it
night.
Was long, long days.
But it was so fun.
It was super fun.
It was a cool experience, but it was gnarly. So we made it all the way to, like, the final tryout to the next part. We would have had to go start doing stunts in the show to get like the next part,
which would have been, you know, a real
show kind of like a real,
well, no, I'm saying that would have been like a real like slap to the face to everyone that actually, you know, did the casting, and they're like, how did these guys make it this far?
I think we would have done pretty good, like, but see, like the show like used a lot of our background and used a lot with motorsports and wakeboarding and like the action sports stuff that you and I have done our whole life.
Your background, never done anything in water, really.
Yeah, but
I haven't.
But you rode moto and like you put yourself like anything behind bars. And
that was the funniest thing too. The guy came up to me and he's like, because we just like we put down like three different positions like to try and audition for, and the guy comes up to me and he's like, so you're good with riding a jet ski? I'm like, yep. He's like, you've ridden a jet ski before? I'm like, oh yeah, dude, all the time.
You got any footage?
I fucking shred jet skis. He's like, yeah, you have any footage you can show me? And I'm like, dude,
other laptop.
That sucks. I wish I would have known that I had to show you footage because it's on my other phone at home. Believe it or not.
Didn't bring it with me.
Yeah, sorry. But I'll tell you right now, shred a jet ski.
Give me, what did you say? Give me anything with bars and I'll ride
it.
Yeah,
I was like, dude, just put a set of handlebars and I'll figure it out. So and the guy just like looked at me and he was like,
get the fuck out of here.
Okay. And I was like, so.
But it was
that a no?
It was pretty funny because like they line you up. It's pretty brutal because like when they do like call outs, they line everyone up in the group and then they just start announcing numbers. You're wearing a number. And so you just see people not getting called. And so like at the end of the, like one of the callbacks, like Devin got called. And I was just sitting there. I'm like, oh, fuck. And I was like.
Oh, yeah. You were like the last
one. Yeah, I was like the last one to get called. And I was like, oh, sick. So
we
were
like both really far down there, though. Like we were probably, I was probably like third to last. And you were
like
last or something.
At least I got picked on like my church football league.
Oh, wow.
At least I got picked in Hollywood. Church football didn't even pick me.
Suck it, church football.
Right? Hollywood liked me. But basically, yeah.
Not enough. They didn't like you enough.
Finally, at the end of the day, like they're going down the line. And Devin and I are looking at each other, like, and we both said, we're like, dude, like, it's going to suck if one of us doesn't get picked. Like, we'll be stoked for each other, but it's just like we've been doing this together. It's like we don't want to drive back by ourselves now and do this anymore.
Yeah.
Well, it was more fun doing it with a buddy.
Yeah, we were going to be super bummed if, like, one of us made it, the other one didn't, because we'd probably be like, yeah, I'm probably just not going to do it.
Yeah. So we got cut at the same time, which was, it was a good time, but they basically told us we had faces for radio.
It was a cool experience. Like, it was really fun, but
I'll do it again. Like, if they do the tryout again, I'll do it again.
I'll give them a go.
I'll do one more. As long as I don't have anything going for 2 days.
Yeah, for like all day for 2 days.
Gosh. I mean,
but that's why we're saying, like, respect to people that do the casting thing, because, like,
it's a gnarly deal, man.
That is brutal.
But we've just thrown ourselves out there at a lot of stuff, and that's how we figured stuff out. Like, we'll literally be so bored at home.
I mean, we pretty much went in going, there's
absolutely no way.
Like, when you set the bar so low,
you got to set it low.
That it's like, if we were going in there going, we're getting cut first round, no doubt about it.
The bar was so low that I was going to trip over it.
So we're going in thinking, like, no way we're going on in hell. There's no way in hell we're moving on. And then we get called and we're like, what the fuck?
Right?
Like, you already have exceeded
every expectation
that you were going for. And then we're like, all right, cool. So we made it the next one, blah, blah, blah. We're getting called back for day two. We're like, there's literally no way we're making it past first cuts day two. And then we come in and they're like, yeah, we'll call you guys in for round two. And we're like, what the fuck is going on here?
Where's Ashton? Bring the camera out.
Dude, so that's, I mean, I pretty much, that's how I live my life, though. Like, I go in with, like, the least expectations.
Expect nothing, appreciate everything.
But, like, I'm coming in and I'm like, I'm expecting the worst of the worst. So then when something better happens, you're already, like, over the moon. Like, yeah.
Right? No, it's like, it goes back to that old saying, like, literally, expect nothing and appreciate everything. Because, like, once your standard is that low in life.
That makes us sound so bad, though.
But it's way more
legit. Once your standards are just at an all-time low.
Well, I guess there's, like, certain things in life you got to keep a standard to. But, like, to, like, most aspects of life, you could just be I expect nothing. I expect, or even to the point of, like, I expect nothing in return when I go into this. And if I get anything back, you can use that approach to anything in life.
That's what I'm saying. That's
friendships, relationships,
but that's
anything.
How I'm saying. That's how I live my whole life. So, like, if I'm, you know,
life's a garden, dig it.
If I'm trying, yeah, Joe Dirte. No, but that's what I'm saying. Like, if I'm going for, like, a job interview or a fucking whatever you're trying out for, I go in just going, like, yeah, this probably isn't going to work. And then when they're like, yeah, you know, I think we can possibly work together and, you know, go on from here. And you're like,
what?
Like, what the fuck? Did you just say yes?
You're like, you're already giving them the...
Because then you're not let down
either,
though.
You're already giving them the, well, I appreciate your time. Thanks for letting me come out today.
I understand.
And the guy's like, no, you got the job, Rick. Yeah, I get it. You know, there's other candidates that are better out there than me.
Everybody's more qualified than me.
The guy's like, hey, no, guy, I want to work. You're like, what?
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying because, like, I mean...
I've always found, though, the interviews that I went into that I overly wanted to get that job. And, like, I thought I prepared myself. I never got that job. But the interviews that, like, I wanted the job, but I was so nervous going into it. And I walked out of there. I'm like, bomb that one. Like, I couldn't even say my name in there. And they call me back. And they're like, I'm like, what? Like, what did I even? Dude, I bombed that.
Yeah, like, you're like, there's no way.
The times I think I bombed stuff in life were, like, my most successful times.
Yeah.
Like, when I literally just went in there and I was like, I walked out and I was like, man, there was, like, 100 different things I think I could have said during that time.
Absolutely. Then, I've taken like important tests on stuff before and done the same thing, like handed it in and I'm just going, yeah, I'm fucked. Yeah. I'm like, there's literally no way in hell I'm passing this. And this is like to get like certified for certain things and stuff too. And I'm like, I just spent money on this. I wasted my time. What the fuck? Like, why did I even try and take this test right now? Like, I should have studied more. And then it comes back and they're like, oh yeah, you got a B on it. And I'm like,
what?
How?
Right? But that's like even like check rides. Like going to school over the years, I used to get so nervous for check rides flying. And like I would stress myself out the night before just like trying to get over prepared. And then I remember like one day I was in a check ride and I was flying with someone and the guy was like, he saw me like super nervous, and he had been flying with me the whole training. He's like, dude, like, this is just another flight.
He's like, bro, you're sweating bacon right now. Are you all right?
Same with me and bacon cheeseburgers before every test. Good luck, buddy. But it was just one of those things. Like, I always passed every check ride, but there was times I was so stressed that like I would get out of there and I would be exhausted because I just had so much put into it and I was up forever just trying to prepare for it and I was so stressed. And then one time, like, I got the mentality of this guy. I was like, dude, it's just like,
wait, I gotta stop you. Did you say mentality?
Mentality. Yeah. I got this mentality that was like, the guy just looked at me, he's like, dude, this is like every other flight we've done this week. All you're doing is flying the airplane. You know what you're doing. You know
same shit. Yeah.
You know this stuff. Like, don't overthink it. Yeah. Just do what we've been doing all week. And
just
then like
you
start looking at stuff like that and you're like, and it builds that confidence. It's like, yeah, you're right. Like, I know my stuff. I know I'm qualified. I know I can do this. Like,
yeah, you're like, fuck, I know this stuff. Like, I feel like a lot of the times when you know something is important, you overanalyze the shit out of it and think of every aspect that's going to go wrong.
Yeah.
And then you're like, oh, fuck. Like, oh, what if this happens? What if this happens? And then it's like, in reality, like, there's like a 99% chance that that's not going to happen.
And even if it does happen, like the wrong thing happens, like I know with examiners and stuff, a lot of the times, like, it's not a one and done. Like, they'll see how you react and you fix yourself in
the
situation.
It's like a driving test. Like, yeah. If you hit someone, like, yeah, we're going to have to say no politely.
This is a hard no.
Yeah. So like if you crash the plane, they're like,
yeah,
probably a no.
Yeah. You're going to get retrained. Yeah, you're going to go back, get retrained.
Yeah. We're going to set you in the simulator there for a minute again.
But you know, like you're doing like steep turns or something like that, where you have to hold the angle and the turn, and then you have to roll out plus or minus 5 degrees, and you have to be within 50 feet of your altitude. And you know, you're thinking about that, and like, it's like, okay, so I blew through my altitude 10 degrees and I went through my altitude by 75 feet. And it's like, the examiner will look at that and be like, well, was he all the way through? Was he over all over the place the whole time, or did he like kind of bounce up and correct? Like, they want to see that you're correcting.
He's like, you know, he tried his best, and that's all we ask for. You know, as long as he tried his hardest, that's all we're looking for.
He's sitting in the back of the sim. He's like, whoa.
And he's like, oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, Jesus.
I love the sim, though. It was one of those things I used to dread going to, and now every time I get to go to the sim, it's one of my favorite things. Because, like,
I feel like I want to fuck around in one of those. I mean, I know those aren't like free to go into, but
no. But I got connections at the Sims.
Dude,
like, we can probably
wanna,
like
you want to like
we can go.
You want to experience a plane crash? Let me know. In a simulator, obviously.
Thank you.
Because I don't want to experience a real one.
Yeah, no.
But if you want to see me, just oh shit.
We could get you on the sim one day.
That'd be super fun. I think
there's probably I could probably get us on the
sim. I'm either gonna crash the thing like 3 seconds in, or I'm gonna be throwing flips.
You'll actually do really good. You'd probably do fine. It's surprisingly, like, it's one of my favorite things when I instructed. Like, I loved teaching people. I can't say that. There are certain aspects of flying I really, really like to teach. Like, but when I go and fly with people.
Are there, like, different, like, simulations, too?
What do you mean?
Like, is it just, like, a passenger plane?
Well,
or do they have like
we're simulator specific for the airplane we fly?
So it's like that's like designed to be.
So my G550 sim that I go in is the same exact as a G550 I fly in the field. Like when I walk in the sim, everything in there is red tagged, like meaning every instrument that's in that sim could go out into an active fleet flight.
See, I didn't know if it was like fucking you can like flick a switch and you're like a fighter pilot.
No, that's not Microsoft SimTown.
Bummer.
But everything the sim's capable of, the real airplane can do. And we could simulate weather, we could simulate turbulence, we can simulate everything.
Seagulls flying into the motor.
Yeah, we can do bird strikes, we can do everything.
Wow.
Yeah. No, it's a good time. The sim's fun.
That's pretty fancy
stuff. We make our training environment exactly as real as it is to keep it cheaper than flying the actual aircraft.
But then you learn too. Like
you learn a lot.
You have every aspect covered. So it's like
the greatest part about the sim is you could pause the sim. So like if you're like,
I gotta pee, hold on.
That or like if you're messing up in the sim and like the instructor sees it, he can be like, all right, hold on, pause, reset. And we could stop the...
Hey, what the hell are you doing, you stupid, ignorant bastard?
Yeah. STEM instructors are always really cool. I've never had a bad one. They're always a lot of fun. But, I mean, it's just that learning experience. And now every time I go to the sim, when it's on a recurrent, since I've already done my initial training and I'm just retraining in the aircraft, it's so fun because the sim instructors will now see that you know how to fly and they'll start throwing new things at you in training. After we've covered the curriculum and we have sometimes you have extra time in the sim, they'll start like throwing different things and showing you what
they do. Do they just look over at you and go, hey.
We're switching to guns.
Hey, do a flip. You won't.
Yeah, like certain schools we can roll the airplane, but like some schools they're sims.
Takes it all serious. Look at this guy.
Yeah, like some schools we can't.
We can flip sometimes, like maybe, I don't know.
No, you can do acro in the sims, but like some of the sims are designed where they have to switch the program to do unusual attitudes, otherwise you'll break the sim. So like certain sims, like they'll tell you not to roll because you'll break the sim. But it's like I've never been in a sim when it, like this actual sim crashes, but like I've been in the buildings. And like the hydraulics go out and it shakes the whole building. Like when the actual like hydraulics go out on the sim, you're just like, it's like, and you're like, holy crap, what was that?
Yeah, that's gnarly.
Yeah, so like, I've never been in one when they crash, but the actual sim will crash every now and then.
Who knew?
Yeah, they're kind of funny looking when they crash. Luckily, like there's been hurt. There's been people that have been hurt. Like
they're funny when they crash. Nice.
No, they look like all goofy on the ground.
Is it just basically one of those like big pod things?
Yeah, they look like spaceships.
It's like a giant like pod just with a bunch of hydraulics under it. Yeah. Oh, that thing's fucking cool.
Yeah, it looks like something out of space. It looks like you're getting a little...
It looks like something that you went like they had at the fucking...
Yeah.
Science Discovery Museum.
Yeah, they're cool. Yeah, exactly. And it's like
that one doesn't look so cool because it was on fire.
Well, that was the Pentagon. Just to show
that's
plane
not
crash.
A sim.
We're just showing plane crash right now. But yeah, the sims are cool, and it shows. We call it the box. So you know, you're getting in the box and having fun.
Do you hot box the box?
It gets hot in there. It gets super hot in the box. There's usually not a lot. It's like crazy because you'll go in the box in like the middle of winter, and it's freezing when you get inside the sim. But it's like crazy. Once you get the sim going and you start flying, you get hot and they're really, really fast. Cool. And they look cool though. Yeah,
that is a weird little doohickey, isn't it?
But yeah, they're a good time. But yeah, that's a little bit of the serious side of our podcast.
That was the serious side of your podcast.
Well, you were giving me a serious side of your life when you were taking tests and getting nervous and.
Yeah, but I was still having fun with that, saying that I shit my pants.
I've had some fun in the sim. We've had a lot of fun in the sim.
I want to go in a sim.
I can probably make that happen. I think I know a couple instructors at the school here in Long Beach.
Tell them to be nice. Because I don't know what I'm doing.
No, you'll be fine. But no, I was going back to...
That's what I want to fly. Give me a sim where I can be a fucking fighter pilot.
Oh, you met Brandon. Remember Brandon at Reno?
Yeah.
We can go visit him up at out in Fallon and go have some fun. He'll put you in the F-18 sim.
I thought you were going to say he'll put me in the F-18.
I've been trying to. I get that ride before you do. I've been actively trying to get that ride.
I've like always want like, I feel like I've always wanted to like take a ride in a jet like that. But if the like opportunity came, I feel like I would shit my pants. I'd be so scared. That'd be so gnarly.
It's so fun. We got to go do an acro day. Like, I'll go out and do acro with you. I'll do, like, a nice, mild acro day. We'll just go out and do, like, loops and
in
rolls.
That, in that cub that you have?
No, we'll do it in, like, the Great Lakes or, like, we'll do it in something fun. We'll go out and do, like, loops and rolls and hammerheads. And
that's just so weird, dude, because I think, like, that just sounds so gnarly.
Roller coasters become so boring after you do acro in an airplane. It's the most fun you could ever have.
I just, like, dude, that sounds so gnarly, though, because it's, like... You're just not supposed to do that in a plane.
Yeah, you are.
No.
Yeah, absolutely. The one like we used to do back in the day, we used to take like the super decathlon out, and it has basically an inverted fuel tank, and so it's a reserve tank. So when you go upside down, it still feeds fuel into the engine, and it's usually like
everybody watching this is just going, what?
It's usually like a minute and a half of fuel, and so like we used to go out and hang the airplane upside down and time it and see how long it would take before we'd start sputtering the engine. So you'd like. You'd see, like, if you could pass a minute and a half. I think my best I got out of it was, like, 2 minutes one time. And you sit there and you just fly it upside down. And the engine starts going, and you just roll it back over and start flying.
What the Fuck yeah, right.
It spun.
No.
I'm not going to do it with you. We do that with...
I know, but I'm just saying. The engine sputters, dude. My butthole is clenching so hard.
All you do is roll it back over and get fuel going back into it again.
I know. I don't know. It just... I don't know anything about flying, so that scares the shit out of me.
But that's something I like to do. Like, even if... My favorite thing to do is when someone tells me they have a fear of flying, I'm like, let's come flying with me. Like, come flying.
I don't have a fear of flying itself. I'm just like...
Well, not even that, though. But
I just don't have experience with it. So when you're saying that you're flying upside down and the motor starts sputtering, like, my butthole would clench so hard.
Yeah.
If we're upside down and the thing goes, blip, 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 I'd be like, I'm out. I'm done.
But no, like,
flip this over, put me on the ground. I don't want to be here anymore.
The fun thing is, like, people that have a fear of flying that have never been in, like, I love to take them on that first experience flying. Like, I love just to be like, get in the airplane with them, and I'll be like, go ahead. I'm going to let you take it off. I'm going to be on the controls with you, but I'll walk them through a takeoff, and I'll let them take the airplane off. And if they don't want to do that, at least I'll take the airplane off, and we'll get up cruising, and I'll be like, all right, your controls. And then, yeah, I sit there close to the controls because I know how far the airplane can go before I have to say my controls back before it's going to get bad.
I feel like I'd be a little nervous to take off.
Yeah, but that's a natural thing about flying, which is...
What about landing? You ever just let them wing that?
I've let people land.
What?
Yeah.
First time.
Yeah.
First time flying, you let them land. Mm-hmm. Yeah, right.
Yeah. I've walked them through landings.
What?
Well, you get comfortable with flying certain airplanes that you know what it's going to do.
Yeah, but that's sketchy because this guy has zero idea what he's doing.
Got to learn at some point.
Yeah, with like a little training. Don't just like, hey, first time? Yeah, land it. Fuck it.
That's if like I'm doing a lesson. Like, I'll go do things in flight to explain what we're going to do landing.
Like, would you let me land a plane?
Yeah. I would walk you through it, though, before we did it. I'd go out and do maneuvers with you and kind of show you what you're going to be looking for.
You have way too much faith in me.
No,
you have more faith in me than I have in my own self.
Yeah, but the thing is, I'm on the controls, too. Like, so I'm going to be sitting there the entire time flying the airplane with you.
Yeah, but what if I just get super nervous and lock up and then I'm just like, Gah! And just crank it.
So I punch you in the face.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's not a good instructor.
I'm not going to let us die.
Okay, fair enough. Fair enough.
You lock up, you make sure they get off the controls.
Does that happen all the time? Do people just like freak out?
I've never had anyone lock on controls on me. I've heard stories of people that have locked on controls. I've never had it
that
happen
has to
me.
Probably that sounds almost more frightening than engine sputtering upside down.
There was this girl that I was hanging out with for a while, and she wanted to go fly acro all the time, and she had never ever
till you found out she had a boyfriend.
Yeah, but she had never been like, she was like the funniest, ditziest girl ever, and she'll watch this and I can make fun of her all day because that's all we do. To this day we still make fun of each other, and she's like the most dyslexic dumb girl out there, but I love this girl. She's hilarious.
Wow.
And so like we would go out flying and like I would legit let her roll the airplane. Like we would go out and she'd be like, I want to roll. I'd be like, all right. And so like I remember the first time I taught her how to roll, we're flying, I was like, all right, Kelly, I have everything set. All I want you to do, I was like, pull back, and I'll tell you when to stop. So she'd pull back on the stick, and I'd be like, all right, stop there. And then, or no, because it rolls.
What stick we talking about?
The control. So on a roll, you have to dive initially. So I would say dive. And so I'd tell her to give me a nose-down attitude. So I would say push the stick forward. And when I tell you to stop, stop. And so she'd push the stick forward. We'd start accelerating our airspeed because you need airspeed management to do this. And I'd say, all right, pull back. And I'd tell her to pull back. And I'd say, all right, stop pulling back. And then as soon as I told her to stop, I would say, all right, full left. And I remember one time, I was like, Kelly, full left. And we're starting to slow down. I go, Kelly, full wall. And she finally just rolls the airplane.
Just crank it.
But she like hesitated on the controls because I was telling her full left and she didn't know what way to go.
She's like, fuck, hold on. I got to hold up left. That one. Okay.
She was such a dork flying, but it was a good time. But it was like situations like that. Like, I'll take anyone out and I could teach them how to roll an airplane. Like, rolling is one of the easiest things to teach someone.
That's crazy.
It's super fun, though. Like, once you figure out, everything's 1G. So when you do it, you don't feel, unless you're looking outside, you never know I rolled the airplane, unless you're looking out the window.
Like, it doesn't change at all?
Everything's 1G through the whole thing.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. How does that happen when you're like cranking like that, but when you just do a little turn, like you feel the turn.
Centrifugal force.
I'm mad. I'm a freaking air pilot guy. Whatever, dude.
But no, flying's fun. Yeah, I'd love to. You know, we got to go up. I got to take you up.
Yeah, you need to take me flying faux show.
We gotta go do like a biplane ride or something. Or go fly the bush. The bush is always a good time.
The bush, huh?
Yeah.
Taking the bush for a ride? Had a kid. Had a boy. Why don't you guys, you know, throw out some stuff for us? What do you want to hear us talk about? All that fun stuff, you know. What do you guys want to hear us, you know, talk about? What do you want to hear us go over, or, you know, get our opinions on?
Yeah, also start DMing us on the Instagram page, because we'll answer that during the show if there's any DMs. We're going to start posting every night that we're live, so you guys know we're recording. If you guys want us to talk about anything while we're recording, go ahead and send us a message. Also, on top of that,
At Just Another Failure Pod.
And then we're Just Another Failure Pod on Facebook. And it's Just Another Failure Pod on YouTube. So, bam. And if you guys want to be on the show, we do. We've had a lot of people ask. We are going to start bringing people on. We're going to start getting a couple episodes kind of figured out. We want to see you. We want you guys to see who we are. That way.
Yeah, we're giving you guys an idea of what we are, just as us two.
And what we're all about. And
we are eventually going to have other people come on that we can talk about, you know, other stuff as well, and get other people's experiences on a bunch of different other things as well.
But what I was saying, we want you to see who we are. So if you want to be on our show, you kind of get the general gist of like what we're about, you know, what we talk about, because everything's a fit, you know, like we're 100% open to anyone being on the show. We are. We definitely are. But if we're not the right fit for you, I mean, we'd definitely love to help you kind of figure out a way to start a podcast. By the way, if anyone wants to start a podcast, I have a good amount of extra gear. I have extra mics. We have extra things. I would love to help someone start a podcast too. I honestly would. 110%. I will donate equipment that I have extra. If you want to start your own podcast, I'll donate any extra stuff that we have for you guys to start your own podcast.
Yeah, hit us up. We got a couple extra mics and cords and all sorts of fun stuff. And booms.
Yeah, so we would love to help you guys any way we can. Because
Matt apparently shops at the fucking podcast Costco store and
doesn't know what he's doing.
Got the family pack of everything.
Yeah, so we don't have extra mixing boards, but we have a lot of extra equipment that basically all you would need is mixing board and headphones at this point. So call us up. We would love to help you guys free of charge any way we can. People have helped us for free. We would love to return the favor and help anyone else we can. So
true, true.
But overall, we hope you guys liked us tonight.
Yeah.
And any interruptions you guys heard during the show, noises in the background.
We got a couple pipes running through here.
Yeah, we got some pipes in the building. So just, you know, try to hear through it. I think our voices are louder than the pipes, but
we'll see.
Yeah, that's just where we're at for now. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Take your failure.
And
laugh about
and
it.
Do a flip with them. What? No, yeah.
Yep.
Failure.
Failing. And laugh about them and face them.
Failures. Fail face.
He's good at the motivational stuff.
Fuck.
Yeah. So enjoy failing. If you don't know how to fail, we'll teach you.
We'll see you guys next time.
Have a good one, guys.